The Fanthorpe Investigations. The Green Children of Woolpit in Suffolk. When we lived in East Anglia before moving to Wales, we came across the story of the Green Children of Woolpit in Suffolk and went there to investigate. There's an interesting theory that when political, economic, or military problems threaten a country, strange events are reported. It's almost as though the underlying anxiety somehow triggers the reports of weird events. Stephen of England was king from 1135 to 1154. Throughout his troubled reign, Matilda, daughter of Henry I, laid persistent claims to the throne. While she and Stephen were fighting for the crown, there was no strong monarch to keep the barons in check. The unexplained phenomenon reported during their long dispute concerned the Green Children of Woolpit. The story is told by Ralph, abbot of Coggeshall Cistercian Monastery. He lived near enough to Stephen's troubled reign to have met and talked to eyewitnesses of the Woolpit mystery. During Stephen's reign, the estate owner at Woolpit was Sir Richard de Cairn from Wicken Hall, and Ralph of Coggeshall got his account of the strange green children either from Sir Richard or from one of his descendants. Another version of the story occurs in the writings of William of Newburgh, preserved in the British Museum as manuscript number 3875 in the Harleian collection. Putting Ralph's and William's stories together, two children, a boy and a girl, wandered into a harvest field at Woolpit. They had green skin and wore green clothing. They told the villagers that they thought they had emerged through a tunnel of some kind, and that their original home had been a place they called St. Martin's Land. Mysterious tunnels and passageways feature in many old myths and legends. The green children had difficulty eating normal food. At first, they would eat only beans. The boy, sadly, died within a few days. The girl gradually lost her green colouring and grew into an attractive teenager. She married a man from King's Lynn in Norfolk and lived a long, happy family life with her husband and children. Now, assuming that the story is basically true, what might have accounted for their strange colouring? Some unfortunate children worked in the narrow confines of copper mines. That exposed them to toxic copper ore, likely to turn the skin green. Were the two mysterious green children of Woolpit fortunate in escaping from copper mines where they'd been forced to work? A wilder alternative suggests that they were extraterrestrials.